Show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? He looks so small, his face and hands so fair. And when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? How could it be, this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully? The Son of God, the angels said, how could it be? How could it be? How could it be?
Thank you, brother, for coming very far away. Get up early, maybe 3 o'clock in the morning, to get here earlier than any of us here. Praise the Lord for that. I know when we all have a heart of service to God and love God that much, doesn't matter how far you can come, and especially the husband and wife said, we love Thai shirt, love our brother, sister here. We want to thank you for being here. And we all bless. And the Lord is happy to see all of us happy too. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, thank you, Lord, for opportunity to praise you and to worship you. Thank you for calling us your son and daughter. You give us freely in everything. And help us, Lord, to enjoy the blessing that you have. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year again. I hope that each one of us had enjoying the blessing of Christmas, that you have some family from far away come and visit you and at least have joy together. Once a year sometime people do that. I have visited my, my son's in-law. They invited me, and their sons and daughter were back east, you know, in New York City, and they all came, and her daughter, who stay here, came to the house, and we have a good time together. I know that God is looking forward to be with us anywhere we are, even longing for us to go to heaven to be with him and with the big, long table that he's going to sit, as Ellen White was saying, that is so many people, the table was so long, but yet your eye was so good, you could see each other far away, that what God going to restore to you and me when we get to heaven. Amen? And so Christmas time is the best time to remember the gift of God that God has given to all of us. And that gift had been overflow from our heart into everybody else around us. Amen? And that's how Christmas is supposed to be. The good news that we have received from God, and we have to go out and tell the world, as Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandment. Tell me, tell other people about what I have done for you, and that's what I want you to do. Today, we are talking about checking our spiritual FICO score. And you probably know that, everybody know that, because every time you want to buy a car, you want to buy a house and everything, everything depends on the credit score. And so do you know that some people can do something to your credit and your credit is falling down and you need to take a look at it. Every year, once a year, you can call up all the three bureaus and call them, hey, I want to get a free credit report. Because they always charge you. But you can get those reports, and you can look at them and check which one is bad, which one is not correct, your name, your last name, your address, and the department stores and things like that that you never have deal with, and you can call them up and say, or write them and say, I never seen this, I never have been doing with this business, take it out. By law, in 30 days, they have to correct it. Otherwise, they have to wipe those things out, and your score will come up, right? But some people have to go to a lot of agencies and paying $500 to $1,000 to do those kind of things because it's important for our daily living, our credit. We have credit card, we have credit for that, for this. And so I want to ask you today, have you ever checked your spiritual FICO score? Have you ever asked yourself once a year that your FICO score in spiritual is still up high? Or is it bad, fair, good, or excellent? Only you knows, nobody knows. That you come to the Lord and say, Lord, what shall I do to get it up higher? So today, I would like to bring you a little closer that to where Paul had been writing to us and give us a warning. That is, where you want to check your spiritual FICO score is when you go and read the book of Galatians, chapter 22. And this, the book of Galatians, chapter 22, is really telling us already what we need to do as we go along in life. Paul had been talking to us about, if you go into arena, for instance, like once every 4 years, you're going to run the race in Olympics. And you practice running every day, he said, but if there is anything holding you back on your leg, you got to get it out. You got to let it loose so you can be free in running. So Paul is trying to tell us that there are things that are holding you back, that you cannot fly with God, you cannot come close to God, you cannot be with God. We have to examine that our life every year. What is it that holds us back this year? Are we have more joy, more peace, more understanding, more love, and patience, and kind, and everything in our life as a Christian? Have we getting all those things? Or are we still lacking? What shall we do? So every year, I remember that when I was young, even though our house was, you know, dirty and not house like this, you know, we have a habit of cleaning it up. And I will go through and sweep everything out, and everything that dirty and ugly, you throw it away, or dishes that never been washed for a while, for a year, clean it up, dry it up, everything we can do throw things away. I remember sometime Dr. Henry and I and a few others of us here come to the church and seeking for junks, and we throw it away, and we clean the church up. The church in history also, and every year there'll be a cleaning of sanctuary, they're cleaning up. There were a big, what you call these curtains that every day, every week, every month, the blood of the lamb is sprinkled on it. It's dirty and ugly, how the sin was. And once a year, they have to take down the curtain and wash and clean. Cleansing of the sanctuary. How about us? Are we taking anything out of us that holding us from being with God or being fair, being good, and being excellent? And God is so mercy, God is so kind, and God is waiting for you and I to call him if you have trouble. And in Jeremiah 33:3 is a very old quote that I always use, and say, call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will tell you the great things and unsearchable things that you never known and never seen. One good thing about unload or get rid of things that we don't need is to open the door and open the room for a new thing that God is going to give to you. God is going to give to me, and God will give to our family. Our storehouse that we use to junk, with junk, have to get rid of. Some people may want your junk. They call your junk become a treasure. Junk of somebody become a treasure or something good for someone. So why keep it? Give it away, the junk that you have, and clean your house up. The same time here, we're trying to say, trying to clean your heart. And your heart will be ready to have room for Jesus to come in. Just remember, always when you go back to Revelation chapter 3, verse 20, when Jesus was standing at the door and knocking at your door. He wants to come in. Do you have room for him? You prepare your room this year for him. Only 4 more days that we're going to be having a new year. That new year is supposed to be a new life for you and me. It had to be a way of life that God wants us to have. But remember, God also said, he said in the same chapter, he said, I will bring health and healing to you and will heal my people. If any of us have problems, as long as we yield to him, as long as we call unto him, he said, I will heal my people and will let them enjoy the abundance of peace and security. Just think about that. God is willing to give you peace and joy and happiness and enjoy whatever you have not been enjoying yet. It could be your family. A new husband and wife getting married, or your kid and having gone away, but God is going to bring them back. He said, I will bring Judah and Israel back from captivities and will rebuild them as they were before. Think about it. If you lost your son, your daughter, or something else, as some Bible said, that for years this Israel was so naughty and they don't believe in God, you don't trust in God, and God sent the grasshoppers and came black that the sun can't penetrate. They can see nothing, and they just land on the grounds and eat up everything that Israel has. But God said, I will restore the thing that the grasshopper taken away from you. So if each one of you have that kind of feeling, that whole year, the grasshopper have taken away everything you have. But just rejoice because God said, I will heal you. I will restore everything for you as you have before. And I will cleanse them from all the sin that they have committed against me. good news. The devil said, run away from God. You have done something bad. Don't come back. But God said, come. I will forgive your sin that you have committed against me and will forgive all the sin of rebellions against me. Good news for this new year. Just think about it, how much God loves you. And when you realize that how much God loves you, you can't get away from God. You got to come back to him. You got to do everything you can to serve him. As he said, you love me, keep my commandment. The two commandments I leave for you is to love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your might, and love your neighbors and yourself. How your FICO score come? Are you bad, fair, good, or excellent? Put that market so you can move on. God is always in the business of taking care of you. He never be in business of take a note and say what you did wrong to me today, but he's in business of saying or improving your life. So do it for God. Do it for your family, for do it for yourself. Then have you loved your neighbors as yourself? Have you showed a kindness to your neighbors? Have you talked nicely to your neighbors? Have you, used the mouth as James was saying, the tongue that we have is very hard to tame. It is the beast, almost 2 inches inside of our mouth. It's very hard to tame. He said, even the big ship can be tamed by just a little rod. It turns left and right, it will go. But your mouth or your tongue is the very hard thing to do. Have you submitted to God? Let God guide you. You speak nice word, encourage word, and build up word instead of cursing, instead of putting people down or make them feel bad. This coming new year, how you do with your mouth and tongue? Is it bad, fair, good, or excellence? But God wants you to be excellent in all things. But yet Jesus said, don't worry about it. I am going to be with you as long as you are touching me. Remember in John chapter 15, Jesus said, as long as you are attached to me, I am the true what? I am the true vine. You are the branches. If you always attach to me, you can do all things. Without me, you can't do nothing. All those bad habits, all those bad things that happen around us is come from the devil. He doesn't want you to become good citizens for God. And he wants you to be destroyed with him. So Paul was trying to tell us that the thing that's going to hold you back and I back from coming enjoy the newness that God has planned to give us is, he said, the acts of sinful natures. In Galatians chapter 22, verse 19, if you have, you can open that with me. The acts of sinful natures are obvious. He said, sexual immorality, impurity and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fit of rage, self-ambition, dissension, fraction, and envy, and drunkenness, orgies, and alike. I warn you, he said, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. Think about it, brother, sister. Don't go near it. Don't let it entice you. And the bad thing is when God said, don't do this, don't do that, or don't touch that, and we disobey, then we know we have problem. Adam and Eve were given opportunity that there were two trees over there. One is a good tree, the tree of life, or one is the tree of death. Don't touch this tree. The moment you touch, the moment you eat, you will die instantly. But you can go and over there and eat that and touch it, and you will live forever. But the devil come and take you away from that tree and eat that bad tree, and you will sin forever. And then he's going to take you to go eat the fruit of life so you can live and sin forever. That's what the plan of the devil did. So he's trying to do that to us today too. When God have the law of goodness and the result of badness over here, we always want to let God to guide us. My dear brother, sister, I want to leave this with you, that all the bad habit, bad practice that we have done in the past, Paul said, if you are with Jesus, who is go against you? Amen? You have Jesus with you. Jesus is the power. Jesus is the God who can give us everything that we need to fight, to win the war. Because he said, I will give you power. The power of Holy Spirit will be upon you. And you know in Acts chapter 2 that how the Spirit came upon the disciple who fasted and prayed for 10 days and their life never been the same. They turned the world upside down. The people who never want to talk to anybody, the Lord put them to have ability to talk. They are able to go out and tell the world about Jesus. In just nearly about 50 years, 60 years after Jesus had gone, to heaven, the whole world of Roman Empire was filled with many Christians. Just think about it, from 12 people. And God giving the Holy Spirit to work in their life. So the gift of Spirit that God giving to all of us is, and as we read along, he said, but the fruit of Spirit is the love, the joys, the peace, patient and kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These are the gifts, the 9 gifts that you and I should learn to cultivate and have it. If you want to go with New Year, get rid of everything else, but take this 9 fruit of Spirit with you, and take the fruit of the tree of life that God given to you. It wasn't God taking it away from Adam and Eve, but God gave it to you now to plant in your heart the fruit of Spirit. That is love that comes from God. God is love. If you have God, you are love. If you are hating people, don't like anybody, you never know God, because God is love. When you have God inside your heart, you will love everybody. Love that God had is not just, if you do this for me, I love you. If you don't do that to me, I love you. You know what I mean? It's just, it's not human love. It's agape love. The love is unconditional. Do we have that? Have we cultivated at all? You love only your kids, your husband. You can buy a beautiful car, $30,000, $40,000, to give to them as a gift for graduation, for whatever it is. But you can't even give $500 or $100 to someone who needs a car, and you can buy the old car. Or you have an old car in the house, and you don't want to give nobody. You just want to keep it there as a souvenir for the next 20 years. Do you have love of God? That you have kindness in your heart? That God probably crying for you if you are like that. I said, I thought I have given you my heart, my love. What you do with it? Don't make God grieve. And God said, I can forgive all the sin that you have, but Jesus said, don't grieve the Holy Spirit. When you grieve the Holy Spirit, that's the problem. He can't come and live with you. Many people said, well, we have Holy Spirit living in us because Jesus said, I will ask my Father's, and the Father will send the Holy Spirit to be with you, to teach you, to train you, to tell you everything that you need to know, and I will be with you forever. Somebody have that kind of feeling that I have always the Holy Spirit, but Holy Spirit is not going to live with you forever either. But He's available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Our condition, is your heart clean enough that God have a room inside? Or it's cluttered with all these things we just read? Or headdress still there, you're a Christian in a name, but your heart cannot forgive anybody. I know you did something for me, and God asked me to forgive you, but I cannot forget what you have done for me. But you can say, Lord, take it away from me. I have a very hard time. Please help me to take away. There was a lady came to the big meeting of one pastor was giving us he said he gave lectures about how to forgive. And at the end, there was a lady coming to the pastor and said, Pastor, I don't think I can forgive. He said, yes, you can forgive. But I can't forgive. I tried my last 50 years. I can't. He said, okay, you and I are going to do the homework. Tonight, I want you to go into your closet and pray to God, and God will help me to remember the problem I have and write it down. What is the sin that you cannot forgive? So the lady came down early morning to the breakfast with 20 pages of what her mother had done to her, and she cannot forgive. And the pastor said, with the grace of God, God can forgive your sin. You probably have many sins against your mother too. But with the grace of God, would you mind to accept the grace of God today? And give all this burden to God, and God will release you. And she said, okay, it has been so heavy that I cannot hold this anymore. I can never talk to my mother for the last 50 years. But God released her. Next morning, she came down and said, Pastor, I feel so light. I now can call my mother's. I know Jesus forgive my sins and release me from all this. My brother, sister, if there anything that holds you back, it's best that you give it to God. For He called upon all of you, for those who have heavy laden. Come, He said, and I will give you rest. Don't be like a group of African ladies that and the missionaries saw them coming to go home, but their head was full of things on the basket, on their head. They have a strong neck, you know. They walk with a thing on their head, and the missionary feels so bad and say, okay, ladies, I want you to sit in my truck, put everything down and relax. I'll take you up there, okay? But the problem is, after he took off, he looked back in his mirror. He looked in the mirror and he saw these ladies sit down with the bags, the big burden still on their head, instead of putting it down. So that's the way you and I are doing. That's nothing different. We never let it go. We hold on to all those junk. So today I want to ask you to give it to God and ask God to help you. David was once see the beautiful ladies, take a shower. You have no business of doing that, but king have nothing to do. He looked down, beautiful lady, she have no, I don't know, she just maybe want to entice the king. So he found a beautiful lady and tell the guard, "Guard, go get the lady to come and visit with me." And lo and behold, they sleep together. And a few months later, she come back and say, "King, I'm pregnant. I'm pregnant, King." And the king now have a thought, what to do. Because all the soldiers were out there, her husband was in there, in the troop of, on the, what you call the soldiers' line, and he sent a letter and to bring Uri to come. And say, "Uri, I want you to eat with me and drink with me, and tonight I'll give you a job to do or a bonus because you're a good man, you work for me. You can go home and sleep with your wife." Uri said, "No, sir. It's no way that I could go out and enjoy myself while my friends out there sleep on the dirt and they're not sleeping with the wife, but I am going to do it? No way, sir. No way, no way, no way." So the king trying to persuade him and give him drinks, and everything make him drunk. So after he drunk, he get somebody to help him to go to his house. But in the morning, he end up here in the palace. He didn't do it. Not the man of God for sure. He won't do it. So the king have to write a letter. "Okay, you take this letter and give to your superior." And the letter said, "When there is a hot war going on, put this guy on the hot spot and pull your soldier out. Let him die by himself." David had planned and plot to kill a man just because he had done something wrong against his wife. Until the prophet came and tell him story and point out that was David. "You, the one who did that thing." And David confessed and wrote Psalm 51. "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a spirit within me. Do not let the Holy Spirit of the Lord take away from me." That's what David did. You go read it. And God forgive him. And God make him a man after my, what you call, he is the man after God's whole heart. How about you and me? Could we go this year, taking all the nine spirit with you, nine fruit of spirit with you, cultivate it to make it grow? I have no time to explain each one of them, but next time we will go to nine fruit of spirit together, one by one, how we do it, cultivate. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord walking with you every day, and the Holy Spirit be with you. May you ask that the angel that God give to you, walking side by side with you, and they will protect you from the devil. And God is going to be happy because you're going to be a specimen, or what you call the masterpiece that God have made you to glorify God. Amen? We will glorify God this year. Happy New Year to you. All right, let's pray. Father God, may your spirit be upon your people, and may you walk with them, may you teach them. Let them know that you love them, Father. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I want to ask you to separate yourself as soon as possible. Maybe we want to get this done like 1:15. Go wash our feet, one at the men's over here at the back here. And I think, where the ladies with husband, what do you call the couple? In the mother's room, right? Mother's room? Oh, at the back here. Okay, I'm sorry. It's at the back. And a woman in the choir room. And sing and pray together and come back. And take every other seat, okay? Thank you. God bless you.